And now, your hosts for Oklahoma football, head coach Barry Switzer and Steve Davis.
And welcome, everyone, to Oklahoma football. Saturday, the University of Oklahoma Sooners won in the Bedlam series against Oklahoma State, 29-10. But Coach Barry Switzer, it was a very costly win.
Well, we had probably the two most important players in your football team. Obviously, the quarterback is the most important. You know, it's tragic to have a good football team, as we do, and come this point in the season and lose the one guy that's so important to your offense, especially in our style of offense, is your quarterback. Jamel Holloway has been a great player for 3 years. We've come to a point in the season, everybody's talked about this game for all year long, the Nebraska-Oklahoma game, and we're in position, if we defeat Missouri this week at home, that Nebraska takes an open date, that we have the game of the year in college football, that we have our number one rusher and number two rusher out for the season, and obviously it affects our football team and how good we are. But at the same time, I think that I evaluate who we have to play, and I feel very confident about their talents and their abilities. I wish they had more experience, but Charles Thompson and Rodney Anderson are good football players. And if we're fortunate at Oklahoma, when you do lose someone, we just don't fall out of sight with the guy that replaces them, because we do have good football players and recruited and his second team roles. And I think Charles and Rodney will surprise some people. So we're still in the thick of things.
Well, there's no doubt you're in the thick of things. We'll be back on Oklahoma football after these messages. The Bedlam series in Norman, Oklahoma, Coach, a sellout crowd.
We lost the toss again, Steve. We've only won 1 out of 9 this year, and we lost this, and they elected to receive. We wanted to defend the South goal. We would have deferred anyway, and they would have received, so it really made no difference. They start first possession of the ball game. They run a quick sweep to the short side, and they lose a yard. Good defensive pursuit. Barry Sanders on a sweep, lost yardage play. They pitch it again. They're going to attack the short side. There's Daryl Reed in good containment. Dante Jones, no gain again. So it's 3rd and 10. First possession of the game, and they come out and run a power off tackle play. Very fine back, Thurman Thomas, for about 4 yards, so it's 4th and 6, and they've got to punt the football. Exactly what we wanted to do, get great field position, kick in the wind for our offense, fair catch the ball at midfield, which we do. We start out 1st and 10 here. Great field position. Tight end to right, we run the option play, we miss the block right there. Jamel's liable to break out. Didn't find him, right halfback. And we run the foot, Lydell Carr, he gets hurt this play right here. Takes a knee shot right there, and he'll leave the ball game. Lydell Carr, and he comes back in the latter part of this series here. We score on this series. Big hold, great blocking, missed tackle there. And Lydell takes a hit right on the right knee right there. And he has stretched knee ligaments now. There's Rodney Anderson in for him right now. He picks up 7 the first time he touches it. Had a great game. Rodney's a good football player, good fullback. There's the handoff again on the read play. We're about 4 or 5.
Brings up 3rd down and 1 now. We're at the Oklahoma State 24.
Jamel sneaks it. 1st down. 1st and 10. His first possession. Tight end. We didn't get off. Option. Jamel jumps inside. Good job of running. 6-7 yards. So it's going to be 2nd and about 3. Option, hand the ball to fullback. Lydell Carr's back in. He thought he would try again and come back in. He thought he just had a knee sprain, but he's going to have to leave again. Good job of blocking center. Good job of blocking Wallen off the whole side. Our offensive line did a great job the entire ball game. Good job of blocking. Run the option play. Reed hand the ball to fullback, and I think Lydell's got to leave right now. He's
it's the last time we see Lydell Carr.
That's the last time
he's
played.
What's his status?
He's hurt right now. He's through for the season. He might be back for a bowl game if it is the type of injury that Richard Dillon had. Option play. Jamel Holloway, touchdown, first possession. 50 yards, and the score going top 7-0. Good execution. No lost yardage plays. No mistakes. No penalties. No fumbles, and we put it in the end zone. Great job, Jamel Holloway. Great job, Patrick Collins. Great little football player. Touchdown, first possession.
And the extra point. And on a very well-executed drive, Oklahoma leads 7-0. 9 plays, 51 yards, Coach.
Kick off well. We kicked the ball with the wind out of the end zone. Todd hit the ball extremely well this day, not only punting. He had one great punt, only punted the first half one time. Run a counter play. Thurman Thomas picks up about 3 yards there. But second and seven, and we run a counter play. Come on, Derek White, support outside. The guy's got a little speed. Barry Sanders gets a first and 10 for him. Corner support didn't get up the field in time to contain it. They wanted to throw deep to the automatic there, and he has to scramble with it because we disguised their coverage. They throw to Limbrick in the flat, and we come up and make the tackle short of the first, about 5 yards from the first. They run a counter play again to Barry Sanders, the same play they ran a minute ago, but he has to cut up inside, picks up about seven. First and 10. Pitch sweep. It's not going to work right here. They're going to take a loss. Good job right there. Vickers, Derek White, 14. Two good defensive backs.
See it again.
See it again. Replay. Run a power sweep out of the power eye position. Thurman Thomas leading. Limbrick leading. Barry Sanders got a bounce outside. And there's Derek White and Vickers to make the play. Second and 14. 4 yard loss. Second down, 14. Pitch sweep this way. Good job of pursuit. Picks up about six, so it's going to be about third and eight here. 36, third and eight.
Then they had a penalty, and then it's now third and 13.
Third and 13. And they come up fourth down here. Fourth down at midfield, and they're going to run a trick play and our cornerback bust here. They're going to run a trick option play. The end's going to make them pitch. You're going to pitch the ball. We run this play out of even. See, our cornerback should have been lined up outside because we had safe return. He should have been lined up in position for a trick play.
First and 10 at the Oklahoma 35.
Run a counter play here. Good pursuit. Good defense. There's Curtis Williams, 93. Good player. Makes the play for a loss. So it's second and 14. They got to throw the football. Gundy throws across the middle. Batted up in the air. So it's going to be third down. They throw one here deep. You can't see it on this film, but this is incidental shoving here. This they call an interference play, and I tell you what, both guys, that's a poor call right there. That was really a poor call. And we write it up to officials, too.
14-yard penalty, gives them first and 10.
Gives them a first and 10 at 25. Instead of punting the football to us there because of that penalty, they'll be able to get 3 points out of it. Ball 25-yard line. The objective of your defense now is to what? Stop them from scoring and force field goals. Good tackle, good pursuit there of a defensive end. 20-yard line. They got to kick the field goal. And he hits it. A good kicker. So their second possession, they get a 3-point play with aid of a penalty, 15-yard penalty on a third down conversion.
So it takes them 15 plays to go 60 yards for the field goal.
They kick off into the wind. And here we go with Bernard Hall bringing the ball back up to about the 28-yard line. So this is our second possession of the ball game. We start out, hand the ball to our fullback for about 4 yards. Rodney Anderson, boy, he got tired in this game. We like to alternate him. Pitch the ball, option play. Here comes little Patrick Collins, first down, 15-yard gain, getting the ball up to midfield. Our second possession now, moving the football extremely well. We're going to try to throw the football, take a shot at Keith Jackson, and overthrows him right there. Going with the win.
Second down and 10 at the Oklahoma 46.
Took a shot at. See, puts us in a long yardage situation, but look at little Jamail Holloway and the defense react. So Jamail just takes it 30 yards on right here. Great football player. Down to the 18-yard line. Tough to overcome second and 10, but I tell you what, he does it in the option game. And so we get the ball at the 18-yard line.
36-yard gain by Jamail Holloway.
Good job, Jamail.
Directing traffic.
Rodney Anderson. Pursuit makes the play at the 18. First and 10 at the 18-yard line. Second possession of the ball game. Hand the ball to Rodney. About three. Tight end of the field, option game. Right here, we had a busted assignment, blocking assignment. Jamail shouldn't have done that. We get back inside, back to back where we started our possession, 18-yard line.
Loss of four.
Loss of four. And Jamail overthrows Keith right here, wide open. Misses him right there. Overthrown, hit him all week long. We kick at a field goal. Second possession, we hit the field goal, so we make. Instead of a touchdown, we get a field goal, and it's 10-3. So we score our first possession and our second possession of the ball game. Hand the ball on a sweep, and they lose 4 yards. They had a bunch of lost yardage plays in the ball game. 4-yard loss. Gundy hands off to fine running back Thurman Thomas as a senior. Told Thurman after the ball game, I'm glad he's gone. He's been a great back for Oklahoma State.
Thurman Thomas, loss of 43 yards on the play. Great effort by Dante Jones. So at the end of the first quarter of play, Oklahoma 10, Oklahoma State 3. Barry Switzer and I will return to the second quarter action in just a moment. Second quarter action begins. Second and 13, Oklahoma State has the football at their own 17, Coach.
They hand the ball to Thurman Thomas. A few yards. Gundy's going to throw the ball. He's got a scramble fake to Utah. And he throws the football, and there's Ricky Dixon, a great player, making an interception. We got the ball at the 25-yard line. This is our third possession. We only touched it twice in the first quarter and scored with it. Now, this is our third possession. It's already in the second quarter now of the ball game. He throws the ball across the middle. Ricky Dixon, a great player, steps in front. Receiver, Hartley Dykes. And we have great field position here.
First and 10 to the Oklahoma State 25 is where Oklahoma begins.
Option play, hand the ball to the fullback, about 4 yards, down to the 20. Hand the ball to Rodney Anderson again, a few yards.
Rodney Anderson on the carry. Brings up third down and 3.
There's Rodney, blows off tackle, an option read, gets the ball to the 10. First and 10 at the 10-yard line. Patrick Collins. Nearly scored. Took the ball to the 3-yard line. They move it back. They call second and 1. We take a 3-yard loss here. And we're at 3rd and 4 right here. And we have an opportunity. And we only have to make 2 yards to make a first down. Mm-hmm. Probably should run the ball at him again. But we're going to bootleg. And Keith's wide open in the zone. And he just overthrows him. Overthrows him. Hits him all week long in practice. And now we miss our field goal. And we kicked the ball all year long, and boom, we missed that. So we get Ricky Dixon, our third possession, gets great field position for us, and we don't capitalize. We don't get points. Our defense has thrown them for more lost yardage plays so far than they've made positive plays. Defense playing well. They run a counter play again. They're going to take a loss. 2 plays in a row, they've lost about 5 or 6 yards, so it's 3rd and long now.
3rd and 16, the Oklahoma State 14-yard line. They will not get it.
We're going to try to run a little draw play, so they're going to have to punt the football to us. So they punt the football, our third possession, we miss scoring. Now, this is our 4th possession of the ball game. We got the ball right here, and watch what happens the first play. Get a penalty, and that was a poor call right there. I tell you what, they called us for clipping. We got thrown down. Rodney Anderson fumbles the football, and they get it 31-yard line. 1st and 10, we get the ball, great field position, our 4th possession, and we fumble the football then, 35-yard line. So they're back to throw, our defense is going to play well. Nearly intercepted right there, great defense. Dante Jones.
They called offensive pass interference against OSU.
They do there.
2nd and 25.
They did on Hartley Dykes grabbing our guy. Here's great coverage right there, but by Ricky Dixon, who is a great football player. He's already Oscar'd one. He's going to Oscar another one later for a touchdown. Had great plays all day long, breaking up passes. Here's a bounce outside right here, and they get close to first down. Did they get a first there, Steve? No, they
got a punt
the football. The defense stopped them. We turned the ball over. So our defense has played great. Really has played great so far. We forced a punt there.
Oklahoma will take over at the 16-yard line. It'll be 1st and 10.
Hey, this is our 5th possession. We fumble the first play. Fumble it. We take this 5th possession now. The 4th possession, we fumble the first down. We take this and we go 74 yards with this one right here. And then fumble at the 10-yard line. Jamel Holloway, option play. You've got to make each possession count. We only touched it twice the first half. Jamel Holloway up to 30-yard line. Option play.
Gains 10, 1st and 10, Oklahoma.
Great player. Option play, run the fullback trap, light up, fumble the game thing again. He got it back. Rodney Anderson fumbled the football. Got it back. Oh, Rodney, wrap it up, wrap it up. 42-yard line.
Another 1st and 10. Now it's 1st and 10 at the 42.
Here's a great job of blocking. Jamel jumps up inside. running tough. Took the ball at the 16-yard line, her own 16 after that punt. Rodney Anderson, big play. Good job, Jamail. Execution the offense. Don't stop ourselves. Don't stop ourselves with penalties and fumbles, and we'll be all right. 5 yards.
Coach, you've gained 10, 7, 7, 6, 8, 6 yards.
Option play. Jamail Holloway pitches it. Stafford into the boundary for first down or close to it. Option play. Great block there. Stafford, Jamail Holloway. 32-yard run. 4 down zone. Let's go put it in the end zone now. Great drive. Our fifth possession. Leading 10-3. We already blew our last opportunity down at the goal line, 4-yard line. Let's go put this in the end zone.
21-yard gain by Jamail Holloway. Gives him first and 10 now at the Oklahoma State 12.
Rodney Anderson for two. Two or three. Second and 7. 4 down zone. Field goal or touchdown right now?
At the 10.
Fumble of football. Go 74 yards. We take it at our 16. We go to their 8-yard line, turn it over. Can't win doing that.
You go to the 5 and the 10.
Make
and
it
get
too
no
tough
points.
A ball game. It doesn't have to be this tough a ball game. Hold on to football. Good job of running. Great running back right there. Bounce out. It's good running. Good defense there. Ricky Lonnie Finch knock him out of bounds.
It's a 42-yard run.
Want to throw the slant pass. Wouldn't let him do it. Skies the coverage. Nearly intercepted there. Gundy back on the drop. A good catch for Gerard. What's his name?
Green.
Gerard Green, number 19. It was a good catch. Good job of tackling.
Second and 8, the 19.
Second and 8. Fumble the football. Percent, pursuit. Intercepted the great linebacker right there. Ball in the air. Dante Jones scrambling defense, threw the ball in the middle, had good coverage on the receiver. And
there's Dante,
right,
that's where he will come in on the play.
We had good coverage. Mike shouldn't have forced this one in there. He forced the other one in there, too. Strikes it, too many good receiver, bang, right there. Ball's knocked up in the air, intercepted right there. Great play.
Well, that is a timely play. Quick thinking, Dante Jones.
So this is our sixth possession. We start out in the 19-yard line. Jamail pops on open field and slowed us down yet. But this, we miss an opportunity right here trying to throw the ball in a two-minute offense. Our sixth possession of the first half. Only touched it 6 times.
Oklahoma was not able to score in this drive. And the Sooners head to the locker room at halftime with the lead of 10-3. Coach Switzer and I will be back in a moment.
You know, like I said, I've always wanted an opportunity, but I didn't want it to come this way. I don't have butterflies yet because I'm still thinking about Jamail.
Now, all during the season, wherever Jamail goes, I've noticed you're right behind him. You've watched, you've learned, you've trained, you've done all of that. I know you have to feel confident about your own ability.
Yeah, I feel confident about my own ability. And the fact that Jamail has helped me during the year, he's been a friend to me. You know, a lot of people don't know that. A lot of people wouldn't expect that, but Jamail Holloway and Charles Thompson were friends, and we're still friends, and I'm worried about him.
I'm worried about him, too. And I'm like Charles. I didn't expect it to come this way for him to step in this type of role, but... You know what? It happened for another freshman quarterback in 1985. We lost our starting quarterback, and a young rookie quarterback named Jamail Holloway had to step in, lead us to a national championship. And Charles Thompson has that type of ability and talent, and I can't expect him to do the same thing Jamel did.
And it happened in 1976 with the Thomas Lott and Dean Blevins.
Right, but that wasn't a season career-ending. Dean missed a couple of games because of that injury, but from that, Thomas Lott emerged as an outstanding quarterback. But these two injuries, well, this injury right here, of course, is a season-ending injury, and I've visit with the doctors, and the doctors say that Jamel will have a good knee. They were really happy with the results of the operation, and that they think he might even make a spring practice. I'm not concerned about that. I want him to rehabilitate and get the knee back to where he's 100% well, where he can perform and play like he has in the past.
Coach, contrast the players Charlie Thompson, Jamel Holloway, and then Rodney Anderson and Lydell Carr.
Well, first of all, Charles doesn't have the strength that Jamel does to break tackles, but at the same time, he has the ability to probably make a big play or maybe a big play quicker than Jamel because of his great speed and quickness. If he gets a scattered field in a passing situation, and we might throw the football a little bit more with Charles because we think Charles can throw the ball well, and he can throw the ball on the run well, and so I think we'll do some things to complement him, but he's not a Jamel Holloway, and you just can't ask a player to come in and be what Jamel is when Jamel has 3 years of experience on Charles. Rodney Anderson has always been considered by our football camp an outstanding running back. He is an excellent football player. He proved that yesterday. Saturday, he rushes for 191 yards in the ball game, and he didn't expect to play hardly much in the ball game, and he comes in and does an outstanding job. Gives great effort. Fumbled the ball a couple of times, but Lydell has too, and that's part of football. I wish we hadn't fumbled the football and taken advantage of our scoring opportunities, but we didn't do it. In the first half, we obviously had the ball at the 4-yard line, the 10-yard line. We fumble. We don't get any points, and we fumble the football, and we made it a little bit tougher than it could have been.
Well, sure, we're going to see about how tough it got. Third quarter action on Oklahoma football will continue in just a moment. Second half, Coach, it gets a little tougher now.
We elected to receive, take possession, 10-3 lead. We want to take the ball, go into the win in the fourth quarter. We run a counter play to Patrick Collins for about 2 yards, second and 8 here, first play of the second half. Jamel Holloway, option, pitch the ball, knock him down. Here's Stafford, good cut inside for first and 10.
10-yard gain, first and 10 to the Oklahoma 32.
Hand the ball to Rodney Anderson. A few yards on the
Rodney
ball,
Anderson,
Rodney.
Ball
option play, Jamel Holloway. We shouldn't have run. Jamel should have gotten us out of that play right there. This is not a good series for us. We won a good series in a lot of ways here because it's unusual for us to do things like we do here. Right here, they get us a mark, and we do something we shouldn't do. We should punt the football. We go on fourth down right here. We get penetration from the right side, and they give us a mark here, and we come up a few inches short. So it's their ball. We should have punted the football away. Stupid play on my part. They run the football. He bounces outside 4 yards, and they run a counter play for a couple yards here. Good defense inside, so it's third and long here. Third and long, wing set. They're going to run a pop play, hit for no gain. It's third and short right there, and they run a play, and it's a fourth down and 2. And so they're going to go for it. They're going to throw a ball in the flat. Good coverage, good force, and it's fourth down. Our defense holds them. My stupidity, not punting the football away. We get field position back here at the 30-yard line. We run a counter play, and we pick up a few yards. So our seventh possession of the ball game, we went on fourth down. Shouldn't have. We should have punted. Here's Rodney Anderson running tough for about first down here.
Why did you go on fourth down?
Oh, our coaches said we were a few inches short, and we just felt like we could make it. But you should always punt the football. Kick it away. Net field position. Hand the ball off. Option play, Jamel. Kept it on the outside belly. And
did Oklahoma State make adjustments?
We throw a interception here. Jamel didn't throw it. It's good coverage by Gillum here. Probably should have gone tight end on this. There's Gillum. Carl Cabinets gets up and runs him down from behind. Gets tackled at the 20-yard line.
Did they make adjustments that made it tougher early on in the third quarter?
No, not really. We, first possession, we went fourth down, didn't make it. And then we throw an interception and, you know, punt the football away. Same as a punt. I'm not concerned about that right there. No run back. We're going to get the ball next series and go score with it. So, you know, we're okay. We just hadn't did something I think shouldn't have done is go for it in fourth down. Defense sacks them here.
On the third and sixth
defense
play.
Playing well. Defense plays well. Jamal's played well. He's got over 100 yards at half and had 240 yards rushing first half. Rodney gets stacked up for no gain here. An outside beer. Counter play again. A few yards.
Brings up third down and 9 at the 38.
Hand the ball to Rodney Anderson. Ricochet through air Rodney. Boy, he's a good back. He's like Lydell. You know, he's 215 pounds strong, got good speed.
That was a 12-yard gain.
12-yard gain. Here's Rodney on a big gain here. Third possession, the second half. We got the ball at the 20, first and 10. Went on fourth down, the first possession. We threw an interception, the second possession. Now is the third possession, the second half. Rodney Anderson gets us in scoring position here. Good job of blocking offensive line. Great job. Juke to safety there. Keith Jackson on the cornerback there, and Rodney's going to run underneath Shaw here.
Three different people have a chance to tackle him, touch him, wrap him up, can't wrap him up. He breaks the tackle.
There's Jamal Holloway, option play. Pitch the ball away to staff. Out of bounds at about the 12-yard line.
10-yard gain.
Rodney down close, inside the 10.
Second and 7.
Pitch the ball. Come on, Stafford, knock him down. Pretty good job there. Oh, right at the 2-yard line. 2-yard line. We got our big backs in, power backs. Bernard Hall puts it in the end zone. Third possession, we take it, touchdown. Well, we miss an extra point here, and this is a critical play in the game. We miss or block the extra point right here. I don't know where he comes from. We'll see it here on, maybe we'll see it on the,
here's the
extra point attempt. Bernard Hall, right halfback, Damon Stell in, Rodney Anderson, good job of blocking Rodney. Good cut, Bernard. Big strong back, puts it in the end zone. We'll have to move Bernard back from tight end because Stell's got to go to fullback. Bernard back to halfback. Eric Mitchell back to quarterback. Ball's blocked right there. That's a critical play. We lead to, should be leading 17-3 in a 2-touchdown lead and force them to have to go for 2 if they can score 2 touchdowns. But we miss. We have the extra point block. Kicking game is so important. And we deep onside it here. We wanted to deep onside into the wind. And they got the ball at the 35-yard line. So we score our third possession of the second half. They run a bootleg, waggle pass. Gundy's going to scramble with it, scramble back the other way, looking for someone. Throws across the middle. Ricky Dixon nearly intercepts it. Great coverage there, Ricky Dixon. Great player. 4-3 speed, great toughness, quickness. And they pitch the ball to Barry Sanders, lost yardage play. Defense playing well. Super play for the defense.
Brings up third and 11 now at the Oklahoma State 34.
Third and 11. Go across the middle. Thurman, they got to punt the football away. So the defense has controlled them completely. We had enough confidence. That's why we went on fourth down a while ago, but we still shouldn't have. Good punt in with the wind. Charles Thompson catches it. We got the ball at the 20-yard line. First and 10. First and 10. Hand the ball to fullback for 6 or 7 yards. Scored their last possession. This is our 10th possession of the ball game, our fourth of the second half. We fumble the football. Fumble the football right here. We get it back.
Third down and 4.
Third and 4. Rodney Anderson, their first down. 10th possession, fourth of this half. Rodney Anderson breaks it. We're going to go score this possession. Great job of running, Rodney, to the 30-yard line. First and 10 at the 30.
39-yard run.
Good job. Running a trap play. Big hole. Good cut, Rodney. Speed, speed. Good job, Carl Cabinus.
39-yard gain for Rodney Anderson.
First and 10, Damon Stell with 4-5, made 5. Damon Stell. And the ball off. Fullback, we got Mike McKinley in there, and that ends the third quarter.
It's Oklahoma 16, Oklahoma State 3. We'll have fourth quarter action after this commercial break. Fourth quarter action now, Coach.
Here we go. This is our fourth possession. Starts in the fourth quarter. Fourth possession, the second half. Option play. Jamel Holloway drops the ball, he didn't touch any tackle. Our coaches say the way the blocking angles are, he might run untouched to the end zone on that play. I haven't seen our study film, but we take the ball, we get no points out of that drive, we go 70 yards, and we end up fumbling the football to him. Miss a scoring opportunity. They sneak.
It gives them the first and 10 at their own 27.
Going to scramble. And run with it. Sprint draw, no gain. Good play there, Troy Johnson. And drop throw, the slant route right here, tackled. Hartley makes a good play. It's fourth and one right here, so they're going to go for it in this end of the field. And we don't think he made it. It's a terrible spot. Terrible spot. Watch where the guy marks it. I wish we had this in replay. They had the guy right foot here. Bruce Stinson will look at
they
that.
They got one. It. It's first and 10 at the 37.
Even their people, when they look at study film, say, hey, we got a pretty good mark on that one. So it made a first down for him here. Throw a crossing route. This is a great play, great run. Runs over the official. Official helped blocks off a couple of our guys. Great effort, but Derek White knocks him out at the 3-yard line. They give him a pretty good mark right there.
Great run by Thurman Thomas, a 53-yard gain.
Barry Sanders tries to go over the top. No gain. Same thing. Great play on third and one. He breaks the play. They get there. When you look at our film, I'm telling you what, should have been our ball going the other way. On fourth and one back there.
Oklahoma State converts.
Makes
16-10.
It makes an interesting ball game. Power play for 4 yards, and you watch little Patrick Collins get ricocheted off Rodney Anderson here, and he stumbles right there, lost his balance, falls down for a 7-yard loss. You're going the wrong way, Patrick.
What you call a stuff?
Everybody's flapping their hands like they did. He didn't even touch a white shirt. He ran into Rodney. There's try to throw Damon Stell. It's a third down and 15, so we got to punt the football. Second punt of the football game for us. And we punt the football, and good coverage. We did a great job in coverage game. So they get the ball right here at the midfield.
Yeah, we pick it up first and 10 at the 41.
Good defense right there for a lost yardage play. Counter, slant pass, batted away. Good play, Richard Dillon. That's one of their favorite plays. This is a third down. There's a rush. Hit the fullback. Flat. Limerick. Slot. One back set. Darrell Reed, sack, All-American player. Great sack, 5-yard sack by our defense on fourth down.
That's right.
Great
fourth
defense.
And two.
Great defense. Defense play well all day long. Great defensive football team. Option play. Jamel Holloway turns up inside, busted. They call a face mask penalty. We wanted to go call it, because our people are screaming over there.
Second and six play.
Come on, Rodney. Hold on the way to fight, Rodney. 9 yards.
And here's the first and 10 play, and this is where Jamel Holloway will get injured.
This is it. This play. And Jamel, is this not the tackle? He does it himself. Wade plants right there and cuts inside. The torque on the field. Twisting on that field, no traction of the artificial turf, his grabbing the turf with his foot and cutting like that. He's made 1,000 cuts that way, though, in his career. But he knew he was hurt as soon as it happened. Great football player. what Pat told me before the ball game. He said, boy, he is a great football player. And he is tough, confident, winner. Right there, his left knee did it when he planted his left foot, because it's his left leg.
Trying to drive and make the 90 degree
tackle. Has nothing to do with it. He's, he himself trying to juke the defender. There was no blow by the tackler, but it was just the torque and the position of his knee. Charles Thompson is only play in the ball game because the defense scores from here on. We don't even have the ball the rest of the ball game because our defense makes plays and scores. Charles Thompson can do this real quick, too. That's why he is a threat. But you see how the blow he took there? Jamel Holloway wouldn't have ricocheted backwards. Right. Jamel would have broken it and gone on forward. But Thompson's a little light. Great job in the kicking game. This is a great, great play by our kicking punt team. Covers, and they down the ball to 4 yard line. Great play. Great play. We never get on offense again because we scored on two defensive scores here. So we never have another possession. They should never throw the football. Scramble got in a hurry. She'd taken the loss. There's Troy Johnson, touchdown. Great play. Troy's a great athlete. He and Darrell Reed are great players, and both are ends. He was dropping in coverage, and Mike probably should have just taken the loss there and got what he could. But he tries to lay it up right here. He looks downfield. He scrambles. He gets in a hurry. Then he sees, looks over to his left, and just throws it. And there's Troy right there with the guy, right in front of him. Troy in good coverage. They drop in. And Troy runs over 62 for the touchdown. Big play. Kicking game got us at the punt down the ball at the 4 yard line. So we go in. We're going to go for two. Duncan Parham's in motion. But we don't even get the 2 point. But we could make it maybe 24 to 10. You know, but we get a no play. So they get the football.
We're going to move it way forward. Yeah. This is 3rd and 11.
3rd and 11, we move it down the field. They've got the ball here. We're leading 22-10. And Ricky Dixon Oskies the ball on this drive, and he goes 95 yards with it. We never had the ball again after that punt, fourth quarter. Ricky goes 95 yards, but there's been one run longer on the interception. Randy Hughes, I think, went 97 against Colorado when he played, Steve. Number 19, the same. He ran from the south end zone to the north end zone. Randy Hughes was a great player, All-American, went strong safety, went 97 yards for touchdown. This is pretty for Ricky here. Ricky, I tell you what, the pros will take this film and look at this guy on this. He's the number one draft choice, will go high, and at great speed. He's got 4.36 speed, and he's gone.
Long way, carrying the mail home, Ricky Dixon. Defense scored the last two times, Coach, and offense didn't help a whole lot the last part of the game.
At least defense didn't fumble.
29-10, Oklahoma wins the Bedlam series in Norman on Saturday. Coach, a little bit your feelings is, I know that the dressing room was very quiet because of the injuries to your players.
Well, I tell you, when that happens to a football team, that can be a demoralizing thing. You know, we lose two players of their caliber. There's one thing about adversity, about when things get tight, it usually draws families closer together, and I think we've kind of had a history of that, and I really believe that's what will happen in this case. I think maybe we set in a trap for Nebraska. You know, I think when they see Jamel Lydell Carr out, and I can understand, well, they lose their two best players, their two number one and number two yardage gainer, that they think, hey, this might be an easy, but they forget one thing, you know, that this series has been something that's been very competitive. Mm-hmm. When we've had good teams, we've played them to a pretty good fit. I've been here 22 years, they've only won 7 ball games, and our football team will be ready to play, and we can play good defense, and I tell you what, Rodney Anderson, Charles Thompson will give them some surprises.
Coach, I think you'll like this week's OU sideline feature because it's from the movie Top Gun, and of all things, the song is more fitting because it's the danger zone.
Thank you. try to have as much fun at Oklahoma as we can, enjoy ourselves, relax, and at the same time do what's necessary to win football games. I've had an intense drive, and some of it may be through fear. I've always been motivated to, I was worried about being poor.
He's the unique and controversial coach of the number one football team in the country. Watch A Day in the Life of Barry Switzer tonight on 5 Alive News.
As with every week on Oklahoma Football, Jerry Park introduces our players of the game.
I'm Jerry Park in the Oklahoma locker room, and with me, the co-USA Wet players of the game for Oklahoma football. First of all, to my left, Troy Johnson. Troy, the interception that kind of put it out of reach.
Yeah, well, I'm glad that happened.
You've been laying back on them, just watching for it?
Well, I'm glad we put it out of reach. It was tough down there, and I'd like to share this time with my teammates, because when it got tough, we got tougher.
Good. Troy Johnson, number 80, with the interception that kind of put it out of reach for Oklahoma. And Rodney Anderson, fullback, shoved into the breach, I mean, on a second's notice there, and looks like it's going to be for the rest of the season.
Well, that's what it says right now. I'm just going to have to rise to the occasion, and my line was blocking real well, and I'm going to run as hard as I can, and with them blocking, I think I can make a lot of yards.
There you have it. Troy Johnson and Rodney Anderson, Oklahoma football's USA Wet co-players of the game.
Two fine players, Coach. Missouri this week, a wishbone football team, and you know, you've got two new players in the ball game. They're going to have to play Saturday.
Well, I'm really not that concerned about that. I really, obviously, I want Jamel Holloway and Lydell Carr to play, but I just have enough confidence in the two guys, and I think that I just know what they can do. I really believe in Charles Thompson, and I think he's an exciting football player, and I think he'll get the job done.
What about Missouri, Coach?
I think Missouri is a good football team. They've improved tremendously over a year ago. A year ago, we scored, what, I think, eight straight possessions against them, beat them 77-0. No way it will be like that now. They're playing better defense. They're doing a better job defensively, and they've changed their offense where they're option football and trying to be ground control and ball control, and they're doing a good job.
Okay, Oklahoma's 9-0. We'll see you next week on Oklahoma Football as we review Oklahoma, Missouri. We'll see you next week.
Oklahoma football has been brought to you by Bud Light. Everything else is just a light. And by USA Wet, America's best tasting sports drink. Clothing for Barry Switzer and Steve Davis is provided by Harold's, Oklahoma City, Norman, and Tulsa.